My little cute friends, welcome to the new academic year. Before the lesson, I want to ask a question. What is the specialty of June 5? Do you know? Yes, that's right. It's World Environmental Day. In your English course book, the unit shows the nature's plenty. This unit contains three chapters. First one, a story, how far is the river? Then second, a poem, the echoing green. Final, the last chapter is again a story, a snake in the grass. Today we are going to listen and learn the first chapter, a story named How Far is the River. This story tells us how a boy fulfilled his long cherished wish to visit an unknown river which was far away from his home. Are you heard about Ruskin Bond? This story is written by the famous English writer Ruskin Bond. Let's see the summary of this story. Listen. Once in a village, in a mountain valley, surrounded by woods, lived a young boy. There was a river which flowed through the mountain some miles away from the village. The children of the village had heard about the river. This egg boy of 12 has an irresistible desire to see the river because he had heard about the rocks, currents and waterfalls. He wasted to touch the flowing water. So one day when his parents were out and knew that they won't come back home till late in the evening, he decided to go and take a look at the river. He took a loaf of bread from his house and started his journey to the river. He took the steep path which went round the mountain and which was frequently used by the woodcutters, milkmen, mule drivers, etc. It was a lonely and deserted path. On his way, he came across a woodcutter who was concerned about the boy when he expressed his desire to walk 7 miles on his way to the river. Having crossed the dizzy wind path, he entered into a beautiful valley where he came across a grass cutter who had a long knife in her hand. She was dressed in a very traditional way. She absolutely had no idea about the distance to the river and how much time it might take to reach there. Having walked for an hour, when the boy was sure that he had walked halfway, he saw a boy. He was driving a few goats up the path. The boy asked the shepherd all direction to the river and was told what it was just around the hill. The boy began to walk with shepherd. He shared with him the loaf of bread that he had brought with him till his companion had to go another way. He was left alone, again with no river in the sight and far away from home. He was lost and discouraged. In the middle of now here, he walked on the hard, dusty and snowy path, passing mud huts and fields. Suddenly, the silence was broken by the roaring sound of the river. The boy was surprised by the sight of the river, which he had longed to see, and he ran into till he was ankle deep in water and enjoyed the feel of the water flowing through his toes. Thus, with a great determination, he could fulfill his desire of seeing and feeling the river. Okay, this is the story. Friends, how was the story? Have you ever made any attempt like this? Okay, good. If you have any experience like that, just write it in your book. Very memorizable. Let's see the important and exam related questions and answers here. Let's see some important exam oriented area. Do you know what are they? Letter, diary, description, slogans and posters are the important exam oriented area from this chapter. First, we're going to see how to write a letter and what is the type of letter comes from this chapter. When writing letter to friends, remember given points. First one, address of the sender. Your personal address should be located at the top left corner of the page. Second one, date. The date is usually located below your own address. Simply leave on line space after the address. Next one, salutation. Do you know what is salutation? Yes. Hi John, dear John, dear Mr. John. This is an example. After hello John, hi buddy, dear friend, my sweet friend, these are the salutation very close or friendly manner. But remember one point, after the salutation put a comma. After the salutation, next contain opening sentence. Your opening sentence should be casual and simple. I will give an example. How are you? Hope you are keeping fine. After that, the main important section, body of the letter. Body of the letter should be brief, clear and not exceed 150 words. Body of the letter contains surely must three paragraphs. First paragraph, opening sentence and the reason for writing. Next, the second paragraph, That is the complete expansion of the first paragraph that mainly contained the answer of the exam question. Next, third paragraph, that is the conclusion. Conclude your letter well. After that, complimentary clause. Do not forget to put a comma after the complimentary clause. Do you know the complimentary clause? That's, I will give an example. With love, best wishes, kind regards, love, etc., etc. After that, give complete the last part of the letter, signature and name. Example, first give signature, enter, next line, give name of your name. Finally, you remember that after the completion of the letter, you must give a border to the letter. Hope you are enjoyed this chapter very well. I think you are the very good students and you are very interesting this story. Best wishes.